Everybody else in my class was into other things, and I was just into politics. The powers that be, the Frankfurt recruiters, were out looking for somebody because they wanted to make a dent in far western Kentucky. Came down, talked to my dad. They visited with him for about an hour, and I was excited because all my life in high school, I went out to listen to Rush Limbaugh in my truck during lunch hour at school, back when you could do things like that.
We're never going to give up. We're not going to give up on America.
And he said, I don't think I'll have the time to dedicate to it. And I was just like crushed. I'm like, oh no, he's not going to do it. And then he said, but my son over there will. And I'm like, what? I will? 12 months later, we won, and I've been here ever since. Our family business has been about customer service. This was like a step in that direction as well, to expand on our customer service and get into public service. When I got elected, I was one little red blob on the end of the map. My first 5 or 6 years here, I was just trying to absorb things like a sponge. I could see it as we built toward the majority of the vision for Kentucky as a whole at that point. The coming session, we're going to be looking at so many issues that are virus related and response. And the budget also will be crafted around that too. When you're dealing with billions of dollars and people up here just think millions of dollars mean nothing. But what I've always tried to do is attach a face to every dollar. It came from a taxpayer, and it's going to benefit someone else. I try to keep grounded of this is life-changing for so many people, these decisions that we're making. With the role, the new role of majority floor leader that I will be embracing, I will be planning the day's activities of day one looks like this, but day 30's got to look like this, and it's got to be spaced out. And my goal is not going to be to push everything off till the end. That's kind of where I will be, and try to embrace that role as much as I can. Bam's just a special, special guy, and everybody loves Bam. I want to be more like him, truly a servant's heart. I used to aggravate him all the time. I said, Bam, if you won the lottery, you'd be broke in a week, but not because you'd spend it on yourself, you'd spend it on others. And that is just the kind of guy and character that he is. The friendships and relationships that I have built here, and lifelong friends, but none greater than Bam Carney.